Good morning to you all. Thank you for the privilege of being with you in your homes this morning. I hope you are all keeping well and safe as we are still living under quite stressful times. Let us open this morning in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to greet you this morning and thank you for your comforting, loving presence with us. Be with us now as we share in this devotion together. Fill us afresh with new insight as you speak to us through your word. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for what you went through on the cross to bring us new life in Christ. Strengthen us in your faith, in our faith in you, and guide us, Lord, by your Spirit to share your love with others. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Today, our reading comes from John chapter 20, and I'm reading from verses 24 to 31. But we're just going to pause for a moment on the first two verses. Verse 24. Now Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with the disciples when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the nail marks in his hands, and put my finger where the nails were, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe it." Have you ever wished you could actually see Jesus, touch him, feel his arms around you, hear his words? Thomas wanted Jesus' physical presence, and Jesus graciously singled him out from the rest of the disciples. But God has not limited himself to one physical body. He wants to be present with all of us at all times, even now. Jesus is with us in the form of the Holy Spirit, and we can talk to him and he to us through the scriptures too. Sometimes we're too afraid to express our doubts in case of criticism from others. But Jesus did not criticize Thomas for his doubts. And importantly, some people need to doubt before they can believe. And I'm sure that's true for some of us. The important thing is, as we will see further in the text, doubt leads to questions. Questions lead to answers. And when answers are accepted, they lead to belief. And doubt has done good work. And so we read on from verse 26. A week later, his disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. Though the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here, see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." Thomas answered, "My Lord and my God." Then Jesus told him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Jesus did many other miracles, miraculous signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not recorded in this book, but these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in his name. So as we see, Jesus repeats exactly what Thomas had said and invites him to touch the nail prints in his hands and put his hand in Jesus' side. And then he says, "Stop doubting and believe." At which point Thomas cries out, "My Lord and my God." Matthew Henry expresses this so beautifully, which applies to us even for today. Reach hither thy hand to him who reacheth forth his helping, inviting, giving hand to thee. Beautiful words. In other words, be not faithless, but believing. For if we are faithless, we are Christless and graceless, hopeless and joyless. That gives us food for thought, doesn't it? Thomas is now fully satisfied of the truth of Christ's resurrection. And I ask, are we? Thomas's doubting, his slowness to believe, may help to strengthen our faith. By his very profound statement, Thomas believed in Jesus' deity, that he is God, not a man-made God, but God made man. He believed in him being our mediator, that he is the Lord, the one Lord to settle the great concerns that lie between God and us, and so establish our communion with God. Thomas stated a vital act of faith to claim that he is mine. This is my Lord and my God. Do we accept Christ as our Lord God? Thomas spoke with an incredible sense of conviction and commitment, as though taking hold of Christ with all his might. My Lord and my God, he is mine. I just want to give you a short illustration of doubt and conviction. Charlotte Elliot was born in 1834. She was an invalid for many years. At a certain point in her life, she wanted to help at a school fundraiser, but was too ill. She felt useless, and her inner distress caused her to begin doubting her faith in Christ. Finally, she wrote that famous hymn, "Just as I Am," as a response to her doubt, which expressed her feelings. Just as I am, though tossed about with many a conflict, many a doubt, fightings and fears within, without, O Lamb of God, I come. Isn't this an amazing description of how we sometimes feel when we might cry out, Lord, I believe. Help me overcome my belief. That was from Mark 9:24. As Christians today, we are the ones who have not seen, but believe. Yet our earthly circumstances can create serious questions in our souls. But we need to remember, silent doubts hardly ever find answers. If we are struggling with doubt, let us find someone with whom we can discuss our doubts, so that we don't remain stuck, but that we can move on from doubt to decision and belief, and by believing that we may have life in his name. For Jesus welcomes us to come just as we are. Amen. Let us pray. Dear Lord Jesus, please help me to trust you when life doesn't make sense. So often things happen which cause us to question our faith. Please take my doubt and replace it with fresh faith in you. We pray this in your precious and holy name. Amen. And so may God bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. And may he give you his peace. Have a beautiful day. And until we meet again, goodbye for now.
Just as I am, without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God. Just as I am, though tossed about with many a conflict, many a doubt, fightings and fears within, without, O Lamb of God. Just as I am, poor, wretched, blind, sight, riches, healing of the mind, they all I need in thee to find, O Lamb of God. I come.